In this video, we will be covering how to use the accessibility checker that is built into Word on a Macintosh machine. The accessibility checker does a quick look over your document to see what barriers might pop up. Before we get more into that, let's run the accessibility checker. This can be done in one of two ways, either with a mouse or with a keyboard. So let's start with the mouse directions. You'll mouse up to the topmost ribbon and press on the word Tools, and then about halfway down that drop-down menu, you'll run into Check Accessibility. Tap that, and it'll pop up as a window pane on the right side of your document. So I'm going to close that so we can do that with key commands instead. You'll hold down the function key, which is FN, and Control at the same time. Tap F2, and as you can see, it pulled us up to the top left corner, highlighting the Macintosh symbol. The next button we will click, so we released everything. We will now tap Tools, which is T. Press Enter to get into that drop-down menu, C for Check Accessibility, and Enter to run that again. Those key commands again are Function and Control together, tap F2, release all buttons, tap T for Tools, Enter, C for Check Accessibility, and Enter again. I did not expect it to undo that. So now that we have it run, we can look at the barriers that popped up, and it categorizes it into one of three different categories, either errors, warnings, or tips. Errors are stuff you have to deal with to make your document accessible. Warnings are things that are worth your time to change, as they'll have a very big impact for students with disabilities or users of screen readers in general. Tips, these are the things you can do to make it fully accessible, but it has less of an impact than the other options. The wonderful thing is any of the things that pop up in the accessibility checker, you can tap on, and if you scroll down that accessibility checker pane, you can see why you should fix it, as well as the steps you would go through to fix them. So it doesn't matter how comfortable you are with Word, it gives you the steps to fix each one of these options. There are some things it can't check for, mainly color contrast, as you can see. Up here in this document, I have very light gray text that is difficult to read. So there are some places where you'll have to make those calls, but this is a wonderful first step.